The Liberal Party has suffered a major blow over its position on The Voice. Ken Wyatt, Australia's first Indigenous cabinet minister, has quit in protest. Live to Sky News political reporter Olivia Casely. Olivia, tensions within the Liberal Party ranks are coming to the fore.
Well, it's definitely a blow to Peter Dutton's leadership. Ken Wyatt, he was the first Aboriginal person to hold the Indigenous Australians portfolio. He's a member of the government's referendum working group and just weeks ago stood alongside the Prime Minister when he held that very emotional press conference in the Blue Room here at Parliament House, where he announced both the wording of the question that we put to the Australian people later this year, as well as the three clauses that would be added to the nation's birth certificate if that vote is successful. Now, Mr. Wyatt, ahead of that marathon Liberal Party room meeting earlier this week, indicated to our colleague Laura Jays that he'd like Liberals to be granted a conscience vote. We now know that that freedom will only be available to Liberal backbenchers, and shadow cabinet will be bound to a no position. A few Liberal MPs, like Tasmanian backbencher Bridget Archer, has already indicated she'll be crossing the floor on this. So, Mr. Wyatt, he's now torn up his Liberal Party membership in protest over this. And while he's no longer in Parliament, so isn't affecting the numbers in a practical sense, it's a hugely symbolic gesture and one that everybody is talking about this morning. Here is Jacinta Price's response to Mr. Wyatt's membership tearing up.
That's Mr. Wyatt's choice to make that. Perhaps he doesn't hold conservative values as he perhaps thought he once did. I guess I'm surprised that he's been in the party, he's maintained his position for this long.
We've seen a slew of disapproving responses to the Liberals Party's decision to formalise that no position. So yesterday, for example, we saw Anthony Albanese, the Prime Minister, and Indigenous leader Noel Pearson referring to Peter Dutton as the crypt keeper over this issue. Now, Nationals MP Keith Hogan and also Keith Pitt, they were on Sky News this morning, and they say that, you know, ultimately we should be able to have a reasonable debate without the vitriol. Here's what they had to say.
This is an important issue. We respect differences of opinion, and we need to have a reasonable debate, not like Adam Bandt and Labor calling people names if they disagree with you.
It's entirely up to him. We are the parties of freedom and liberty, and you know, people come and go. People are free to make their own decisions. But I want this to be decided on the information and the facts, Laura, not feelings and not the name calling and things that we're seeing in recent days. It's a decision for the Australian people.
While the opposition backs constitutional recognition for first Australians, they don't think that any voice to Parliament should be enshrined in the Constitution or the nation's birth certificate, and they also think it should be local and regional focused. The fallout from that position announced earlier this week still continuing to reverberate today.
Olivia Casely, appreciate the update. Thank you.